Now, once again, Raymond Arroyo.
Welcome to the World Over After Show. My guest is one of my favorite novelists. He's an arts and humanities professor at Santa Clara University in California. He's written some unforgettable fiction, including Mariette in Ecstasy, Atticus, The Assassination of Jesse James by the Coward Robert Ford, and his most recent efforts, Exiles, and his latest book, A Wild Surge of Guilty Passion. And I don't have a cover here. I took all the covers off because I was traveling in a plane.
Yeah,
Ron Hansen is with us. Thank you, Ron.
Good to see you, Raymond.
Now, I wanted to pick up on something I asked you in the show, and we moved past quickly because I was probably interested in something else or picked up another thread. I asked you why you jump around from genre to genre. Most writers, when they hit a vein and they have a success, as you did with Desperados and The Assassination of Jesse James, why didn't you just keep going on and being the Louis L'Amour of Catholicism?
I felt I covered the ground, and I have to keep myself from getting bored by going into new terrain. Plus, I'm one of the worst channel surfers ever, and in that
you like to.
I don't change channels a lot. I just get stuck on any channel I go to.
Oh.
If it's a Korean cooking show, I watch that for a while because I'm just interested in a lot of different things. And you never know what you're going to pick up. And so a lot of the books I've written are a product of just a wide-ranging habit of browsing in bookstores.
Let's go through the list of some of your biggest books that people will certainly know.
Okay.
Mariette in Ecstasy, what was the inciting incident or bit of information that drew you to that story?
I came across a book of photographs taken of Thérèse of Lisieux by her sister when she was in the convent. Oh. And I was really intrigued with the look of a cloistered convent, and especially in the 19th century. And I thought, if I don't write this book, who is going to? Nobody else is out there interested in this subject. And so that's why I got into that. One of the lines, the last line of that book, actually came in a class I was taking on Christology. And Father Fran Smith was guiding a woman about whether she should enter a convent. And she said, I've been praying about this for months now, and I have no idea which way God wants me to go. And he said, well, maybe God is saying, surprise me. And as soon as I heard that, I knew that was the last line for the book.
The book. It's a beautiful book. If you haven't read it, it's a woman who's experiencing the stigmata and what she goes through in the convent, and whether this is authentic, not authentic, is she being called, is she not? It's a beautiful, fantastic
book.
Thank you. You also did a romantic comedy.
Right.
Isn't it romantic?
I was on a bus going across Nebraska, and it was a terrible bus and terrible weather. And there was this French couple who obviously did not know any English. And the bus driver is yelling at them, and they because they couldn't understand. And I thought, what if they got waylaid in a small town in Nebraska, and what it would it be like for them? And so I invented this little town called Seldom, Nebraska, and put them there. Okay. I wanted to do a kind of Preston Sturges screwball comedy.
Yeah, it's fun.
Hope I succeeded.
No, it's fun. It's a fun little romp. Tell me about Desperados and The Assassination of Jesse James.
The Dalton Gang was a gang that got wiped out in Coffeyville, Kansas in 1892. They tried to rob two banks at the same time. And they were directly imitating the Jesse James, Cole Younger gang.
Right.
And because I was studying about the Dalton Gang and I was learning about the Jesse James gang, and I was asked after Desperados got published,
what do you want to do next?
I was asked to write a short story about the Old West. I said, okay, I'll tell you how Bob Ford actually shot Jesse James, because I knew no movie had done it correctly, and no novel had done it correctly. And so I started writing the story, and it was about 30 pages, and I hadn't even scratched the surface, so I decided to do the whole novel. But I think of Desperados as kind of a daytime book, and Jesse James is kind of a nighttime book.
Yeah.
It's much darker.
It is. It is.
Partly,
but you feel they're connected almost. They're like brothers.
Yeah. And even though it seems like a Western, it's really a gangster novel, because it's just like in The Sopranos. You're steadily bumping off all the people who could turn on you.
Right.
And that's
right.
What Jesse James was doing.
Now, in all of these works, and I mentioned it on the show, there is this sense of grace, the possibility of redemption constantly held out to these people.
Right.
And they're swatting it away at every turn like so many.
Exactly.
Is there an evangelical motive in your work, would you say?
Well, Perhaps. I think, you know, it's always been said that writing is to educate and entertain. Mm-hmm. And part of that education, I think, is to pay attention to God. And so that's evangelical. But I don't hammer it. And it's not at all dogmatic.
No.
I'm just trying to have people aware of the experience of prayer, the experience of God's grace.
Mm-hmm. And the reflection of both grace and evil. I mean, you
right.
feel that.
Oh, you have to treat evil.
Yeah, well, I'm thinking of Hitler's niece.
Yeah. Oh,
which,
right. Oh, yeah.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, that was really, this was Geli, the niece
Geli
of,
Raube,
of Hitler. Where did you discover her?
I did the spiritual exercises of St. Ignatius in one of the meditations.
Where, in the Weimar Republic? Where did you go? Where did you do this? What are you talking about?
But one of the meditations is to think of a figure of pure evil and how he sucks people in. Mm-hmm. And so I thought, in my meditation, mm-hmm. well, Adolf Hitler, he got a whole nation to follow him.
Right.
And how did he do it? Mm. And so then when I discovered Geli Raube, who he said was the only woman he ever loved or would ever consider marrying, and she happened to be his niece, I thought that was an intriguing concept. Mm-hmm. And also it's with that, Hitler has not read gotten to power at the time I'm writing.
That's right.
So it's how do you notice evil when it's in its incipient stages, when it's not yet arrived? Mm-hmm. How do you, what are the little things?
And the little tells.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's
so
fascinating.
I was fascinated by that.
You once said in one of our earlier interviews that you saw Mariette in Ecstasy and Hitler's niece as bookends.
That's right. Because Mariette in Ecstasy is obviously about a young woman who has an ardent love affair with God. Mm-hmm. And here's a woman who has a love of her uncle, but discovers that he's pure evil, and that's why she's killed eventually.
Yeah, amazing. Atticus, before we go, one of my favorite books.
Thank you.
Where did that come from initially?
I was in Mexico at one time, and I saw a man looking for somebody. He was going to posadas and holding up a picture, and they'd say, no, I don't know who it is. Oh. And I was really intrigued by that. And he was walking around with a detective who was wearing a trench coat and everything, but he was obviously a cattleman. He had the cowboy hat and boots and all that stuff. And that just touched off this whole idea of what's it like to lose somebody in Mexico. And Mexico is enchanting to me. I just love being down there. But almost anything can happen in Mexico, too.
Right.
And I lived one summer down there. A friend of mine down there actually got involved in murdering somebody.
Wow.
And he ended up going to jail, and that was part of it, too.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Well, it's a fantastic book. It's really the prodigal son in many ways. But, boy, is it a beautiful book,
thank you.
As are so many of your works. Ron Hanson's A Wild Surge of Guilty Passion and Exiles are both available at bookstores everywhere and the usual online outlets. As I said in the show, keep in mind the subject matter of Wild Surge is for mature adult readers. Thanks for being in the After Show, Ron Hanson. Thanks so
Thank
much
you,
for
Rana.
Being here. And we'll see you next time on The World Over Live. Bye now. That was fantastic.
Thank you.